Brother, sisters, our main speaker did not need any introductions. With further ado, without introduction, I don't need introduction, I mention again, is my great honor and call on the stage our Imam Shamsi Ali to the podium. Imam Shamsi Ali, without introduction, I don't need any introduction. So all you know who it is, and this is Imam Shamsi Ali.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa shukurillah. Salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim. Allahumma allimna ma yanfa'una wa anfa'na bima'allamtana wa rizukna fahma wa wafiqna lil'amal bihi ya rabbal alameen. I would like to begin by following up the prayer that Sheikh Junaid mentioned. May our doctors have more customers for general checkup only. So I pray for your health, inshallah, and may Allah give us and bless us with health. Brothers and sisters, the ayat that I recited in the beginning, if you have listened carefully, at least contain three important points, in addition to about charity. So the main point is about charity, but in addition, there are three important points Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala added into those ayat. Number one is about ash-shaytanu ya'idukum al-faqr. It talks about how shaitan forced us into a situation of being poor. And I think tonight shaitan is playing very hard because they wanted us to make poor. So hopefully shaitan will be thrown away by our imam later on, so they can, inshallah, be richer and richer by giving more tonight. Secondly, the ayah talked about وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. The real wise person tonight is the one who is giving you more. And that is a great blessing in it. The greater hikmah is by giving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But also the ayat mentioned about nasrum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, that as we are struggling at the moment to develop our community and to make sure that our future generation will remain on the straight path, we need the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come certainly through charity tonight, inshallah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala included all these three points in the ayat of charity, which was recited in the beginning of this program tonight. Brothers and sisters, recently a professor at Yale University studied the language of the Holy Quran. And at the end of the day, he was so amazed by the amazing language of the Holy Quran, namely the Arabic language. And he almost embraced Islam because of that. It's a matter of the guidance. He mentioned many, many points, but I'd like to begin with this point that he mentioned in his articles, in his thesis, basically in his writings. He found that the Arabic language in many ways is so balanced, but particularly when it comes to the word plural, normally it has two. There are many words in the Holy Quran that has two forms of plural. When you have in English, brothers and sisters, you have house, the plural is houses. And then you have mouse, the plural is mice. Ask any English teacher why it's different. The sound is the same. House, mouse, but why is not mice or mouse or mouses? Why mice? I asked one of my students, he's a convert. He's a veteran English teacher, have been teaching English for the last 35 years. And he said, this is the way English trick us. It's a confusion. But Arabic language, when it comes to the language, for example, ni'mah, and particularly this professor chose this word ni'mah, it has two plurals. Number one is ni'am, and number two is al-nu'um. And he analyzed for many years why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used two words for this particular word ni'am. And he found that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expresses his ni'mah who comes down from him to us, he uses the word ni'am. وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his ni'am, physical and non-physical, continuously without any limit. Just to remind you that the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no limit. We are the one who limits the bounds of Allah. We are the one who limits the ni'mah of Allah by our own definition. But when we come to our shukr, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is the most thankful person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But still Allah used different plural. What Allah says, shakiran li'an'umihi. He used the word an'um, not ni'am. Why? Because his ability to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so limited. So brothers and sisters, imagine tonight that we are here, we want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother, the oxygen that we breathe in and out is unlimited for free. You can imagine if Allah holds that for 5 minutes, you're not waking up tomorrow anymore. But Allah is giving his oxygen continuously. The second word that he found in the Holy Quran is the word sumbulatun. Allah uses two times, welcome, two plural. Number one is sumbulat in Surah Yusuf. When the king had dream, then he saw that sumbulat. And then number two is sanabil in Surah Al-Baqarah. Now what's the difference between sanabil and sumbulat? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about charity, you are planting seeds. And that seed has become sanabil. And sanabil means has no limit. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. Allah multiply the rewards that you are given tonight. There's no end unto it when it comes to the issue of charity and donation. Brothers and sisters, the reason I mention this, because we want our generation to understand fully the Holy Quran. If the non-Muslims study the Holy Quran so deeply, how many of us have read the Holy Quran and really understand this kind of balance of the language of the Holy Quran? We read Surah Al-Fatiha at least 7 times daily. If I ask tonight the question, what do you know about the Surah Al-Fatiha? Surah Al-Fatiha contains 2 general meanings, about ilm and about amal. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malik, Yawm al-Din. It's about knowledge. And the rest is about amal. Out of these 2 meanings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala produces three types of people. If you combine ilm and amal, you are on the sirat al-mustaqim. But if you have only knowledge, and you don't implement it, you don't do it, then you are becoming al-maghdub. But if you have amal, but without knowledge, you are a dhalin. Imagine, Surah Al-Fatiha, it has knowledge and amal, and it produces 3 types of people. And every human being here in this world is in any of these 3. Either you are Surah Al-Mustaqim, or maghdub, or dhalin. Alhamdulillah, the Holy Quran. The reason I mention this, brothers and sisters, just because I want our generation to come to understand this kind of blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, we are living in the world of full of paradoxes. The more people feel knowledgeable, the more ignorant acts happening in the world today. Look at what is happening to Yemen. The worst disasters ever happened. That is in time. The people consider themselves more civilized, more advanced. The question is why, brothers and sisters? The answer is very simple, because we are living in possibly a wrong civilization. And at the end of the day, Islam must be at the front line to become an alternative to our current civilization. The civilization is lacking of faith. And when we talk about lacking of faith, there are 3 things that need to be handled. Number one, lacking intellectual capacity. Number two, lacking spiritual capacity. And number three, lacking moral ground. At the end of the day, what I would like to mention is that our world is in need of Iqra civilization. Who read Iqra bismi rabbika our chairman. This is the conclusion of civilization that our world is in need of today. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. If you study carefully about this ayat, brothers and sisters, that our world today is in need of this type of civilization that combines three things. Number one, intellectually advanced. Alhamdulillah, today we have a lot of intellectual people. We have a lot of smart people. We have a lot of intelligent people. But number two, must be grounded spiritually. And that's what our civilization today is lacking. But more importantly, our civilization is in need of moral ground. Why? Everything is upside down at the moment. The good has become bad, and all the time the bad has become good. When you talk about human rights, for example, how many people are talking about human rights? And the issue that they are defending, basically, is the destruction of human rights. Why? Because the most important human rights in our life is about protecting our own fitrah. The truth is being destroyed. It's destroyed. You're talking about natural marriage. You're talking about natural life in general. And people are attacking the natural marriage. And people are attacking our natural life, destroying our fitrah. That is not human right. This is destruction of human right. But they upside it down. If you are defending the sins, if you're defending the destruction of human rights, they say you are defending the right. Brothers and sisters, that is the civilization that we live in. And we need an alternative civilization. That alternative civilization will be built by our future generation who studied Al-Islam, who are intellectually capable, who are morally grounded, and spiritually healthy. That type of student that we have at our Mamoor school. And we need that facility to enable them to grow so that they can be in the front line to present this new civilization in the 21st century. So let me end with this, brothers and sisters. Your presence tonight is hopefully giving one brick to that new alternative civilization for our humans to live their life in the future. Do not underestimate how much you give tonight. Even just a little. But inshallah ta'ala, we are not depending on how much. We are depending on the barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when you eat, it is not that much. It's not about how delicious it is, how much it is. You are asking the barakah. Allahumma barik lana fi ma razaqtana. So hopefully, my brothers and sisters, number one, shaitan will be thrown away by our imam later on, inshallah. Because if you're listening to his voice, everyone's going to wake up. And the shaitan is going to run away. With that, our hand will be easy going inside of the pocket and take out your money for the future generation and the future of human civilization, inshallah ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ITV, call of peace, save humanity.